The big donation bundlers who supported Barack Obama and Hillary Clinton back during their presidential runs have not all gone all in on any candidates just yet, but they are starting to pick who they might want to support in this Democratic primary. Of 1,924 big donors, 425 have contributed to the current field of candidates. And so you're obviously curious at this point, who are they supporting? We've got a cool looking but hard to decipher at this size chart for you. So I will summarize. So you see that a big chunk of those who supported Hillary Clinton are now supporting Kamala Harris. That's, I believe, pretty much by far the biggest area where Clinton backers are going. The people who supported Obama, who did the big fundraising for him, you see that they too are going towards Harris, but also Buttigieg and a number of others. Those are the ones that are sort of focused on in terms of the numbers. Harris has received donations from more than twice as many top Democratic fundraisers as her next closest competitor, Cory Booker. Well, actually didn't see on that chart, but apparently he got a lot too. Who got donations from 80 Obama and Clinton bundlers in the first quarter. Gillibrand got donations from 67. Amy Klobuchar from 61. Pete Buttigieg, 51. Quite a bit considering that most of these donors probably weren't that familiar with him prior to the last couple of months. And so as with a lot of areas of this, this election, Buttigieg is skyrocketing. Not necessarily amongst the small donors. We've talked about that previously, but this is amongst the exact opposite end of the scale.
Go.
Yeah, I get it. Like, it makes sense to me. There is this thing. I feel like there's two groups of Democrats. There's the Democrats who are like the working class folk who are looking around for someone to rally to, and then there's the people who are very liberal, wealthy city folk who are like, I want to make a difference. I put on my North Face fleece every day and I'm ready to donate. And I need those people and I really like them. And I know that a lot of times when I talk to them, we find a lot of common ground. Those people seem to, when you start talking to them, say things like, I hate Bernie for what he did to Hillary. And then everyone just goes back into a fight they had in 2016. What I see play out in this is there are people who have a lot of money. They like Kamala Harris, and it seems like that's the person that they're rallying around.
But why are they rallying around certain ones of these people? Because in reading the depths of the bundlers and the handlers and the collectors and the telemarketers and this whole process of getting people to donate, it doesn't necessarily go straight to, hey, you know what, I like that person's policies, and I'm gonna give my $100 to them, whatever it is. It's, hey, if you want this kind of thing to happen, give it to me, and then I'll make sure I give it to the right people that you're gonna make sure it supports what you want, and we call that small dollar donations. But then when the big corporations and rich folks give all their thousands of dollars at a time, and pledge they're gonna give millions of dollars later when someone comes in, that's what we're really waiting on. So you need to get the startup going of saying, I got people that are getting all the small things collected and giving to certain people to give them an edge so that later people with the bigger money or people that are now gonna wait until the general election start giving will say, hey, I see everyone gave to Kamala, everyone gave to Gore and Cory Booker. I think I will now too. None of it has much to do with the thought process of what the person's doing. It just has to do with convincing enough people to give enough money to make someone look a certain way so that other people will give money later. Well, it doesn't make much political sense.
And it's also important to note that this is not a gigantic, this is about 1 in 5 of those big bundlers from past elections, but we're still very early on this process. They could simply wait and have a better idea of who their person is going to be. I think that they are choosing to get engaged into this race a little bit earlier than they might otherwise because of the front runner status of declared candidates of Bernie Sanders, who you'll note was not mentioned in those who had received a bunch of the bundler donations. He did receive from some two, which is actually one less than Marianne Williamson, who has not really been a big, like I talked to her on the damage report. We had a great conversation, but she is not exactly a tier one candidate at this point and has received more support from those big bundlers than Bernie Sanders.
The big point that I want to find more out about is are these the same people?
As the same people as what?
So does someone who gets money together get money together for Kamala and then has another dinner and gets money together for Amy? And then has another dinner and puts it together. And I think that could address your concern, which is, you know, maybe someone else gets in the race, maybe some development happens. That won't stop them from raising money for two reasons, and I don't know if it applies to everyone who's giving money. One is, I wanna make that difference. I think the working class folk, I wish it was easy to communicate to those people that it's more than just the kind of surface level, you know, big city North Face fleece and things. It has to do with like getting jobs and empowering unions and making the blue collar life more dignified like it used to be, when I think the people who donate are just detached from that. But another thing is that a lot of them just really like that access. They really like being able to say, I can call that person on the phone and they'll take my call. And the reason is that I give them money,
that's
but
just
they
not
just
what
don't
I'm interested
want
in.
Yeah, I know, that's. But I'm just trying to explain things.
Now, it is great to see that despite the early efforts of people like this, I mean, there is a bigger focus on small dollar donations. The DNC is requiring a significant number of those to be on the debate stage at all. And I'll just briefly mention this, we have talked about it before. Through the first quarter, the most fundraising has gone to Bernie Sanders, who's gotten $18.2 million. It's a pretty big drop off to second, Harris at $12 million, O'Rourke at 9.4, and then it goes down Buttigieg, Klobuchar, and Booker.
Are those small dollar donations or total?
That's total right there. And for comparison's sake, I believe that back in the 2000 cycle, at the same in the first quarter, Hillary Clinton and Obama had raised like 24 and 27 million. I forget which is which. But so obviously more than any of these candidates, but there were fewer candidates for the money to go to.
Correct.
So just bear that in mind.
On the go? Don't worry, we got you covered. You can still listen to TYT at our new podcast network. Find us on Apple Podcasts, the Google Play Store, or at tyt.com/podcasts.